42 degrees, 4 seconds.
Darn, I'll never get this right.
Like the try double or nothing?
Your odds of winning, 3.253 to 1.
Computers, they're everywhere. There's no escaping them, no matter who you are. Look at me, Elaine Joyce, actress, singer, dancer, an entertainer. I've worked all my life to hold this spot right here, center stage. And just when everything's starting to click, am I about to be replaced along with every other musician and artist by these machines, these computers?
Elaine, you must remember, computers are people too.
Computers Are People Too is brought to you in part by Atari, a family of home computers and video games that challenge you to discover how far you can go. And by these fine Scott paper products that bring you the exciting Scott Tron Sweepstakes. Watch for details later in this program.
Atari brings the computer age home.
Ready?
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Not quite. Try one more time.
Learn a new language or take your best shot at missile command. With an Atari 400 home computer, there are a world of possibilities. In fact, it could even change your life.
Bonjour, grand-mère. Grand-père. Comment allez-vous?
The Atari 400 home computer. We've brought the computer age home.
Mom, look. Just like the end Sunday's paper.
Enter the world of Tron with the Scott Paper Scott Tron Sweepstakes.
What can we win?
A family vacation for four to Hollywood and Walt Disney Studios, where the new movie Tron was created.
Fantastic!
And thousands of other prizes, like in television game consoles, plus money-saving coupons. And get a free Tron T-shirt iron-on with the purchase of two participating Scott brands. Look for details on the Scott display at participating stores.
Let's look at this rationally. Only a few years ago, computers were no problem for me. Grandma here belonged solely to the scientists and the mathematicians. She was the first electronic computer, born in the 1940s.
X equals...
She gobbled electricity, but didn't store much information.
The square root of A squared...
She was overweight, hard to operate, frankly, not much competition.
Lately, computers have become smaller and easier to understand.
Not for me, they haven't. This is the newest upstart. You'll find him in every home, like an alley cat that wandered in and wouldn't leave. He's got his nose into everybody's business.
Third warning. Your car needs an oil change. You've exceeded your caloric intake for the day. Your bank account is overdrawn. $311.12.
An electronic epidemic has overtaken us in less than half a century, just like the Great Plague. Here's the computer of the future, Telecommunicative Operative Memory, Tom for short. A computer that talks to you and lets you read his mind.
We're an extension of a person's intelligence. We teach when used by teachers. We're artistic when used by artists. If you're an entertainer, so are we.
If you're an entertainer, I'm out of a job.
Not so. We are on the verge of a beautiful partnership. When artists like you learn to use us, I amaze even myself. We can elevate dancers and athletes to new heights. We are the artist whose work can outshine paint and canvas. We're the musician whose keyboard stores a world of sound.
We have a little dog. We can make him a bigger dog, or we can make it a pack of dogs.
See how my drum playing friends do this.
We're the creators of games. We're the makers of movies that stir the imagination, and gliders that sail to the stars.
I'm more dazed than amazed. But if you're proposing a partnership, well, how could I work with you when I have no idea how you think?
Microchip Brilliant processor, 8-bit character data, 64 megabyte memory, user interface with alphanumeric keyboard, CRT.
Silence, s'il vous plaît. They'll run on forever if you let them. How do we think? Ask a dozen experts, you'll get a dozen answers.
How does a computer think? How would you answer that question? That's almost an impossibility.
Oh boy, I'm not prepared for that one.
Computers essentially do three different things for you. Three different things. Well, no, they don't, sorry.
Computers think in about the same way that a horse or a car... Let me start over.
Computers don't think. Computers only have the ability to compile information, and by compiling the information in certain forms, give the illusion that they're thinking.
If these people don't know how you think, then who is in control? I've seen it 100 times in movies. People put their trust in computers and the darn things go crazy. They try to take over.
That's science fiction. The fact is, you're in control. You don't have to know how an engine works to drive a car.
I can hit the brakes. I'd rather walk.
Attitudes like yours are changing. Look at the splash young people are making in the world of computers. Over half the high schools in the United States have some type of computer. And by 1985, we'll be in 2 million American homes. These children attend a summer camp near Santa Barbara, California, where their activities include several hours of computer instruction daily. And a little recreational computing at night. The founder of Computer Camp, Dennison Bolet, first worked with us when he was 13.
If a camper arrives knowing absolutely nothing about computers when he gets here, within the 2 weeks that he spends here, he will come out with a working knowledge of the basic language, as well as just an understanding of how computers work and how to go about learning how they work. They can't learn, obviously, in 2 weeks, everything about how a computer operates. But if they can learn how to learn how a computer operates, they're all set. So they learn how to read the instruction manuals, how to approach a new computer system when they see it, how to approach a programming task. From that point on, they can learn with much less assistance and quite a bit on their own.
8 plus 16. Over half the children here have never worked with us before, but they catch on quickly. This class is learning to design images on a video screen. The instructor, Mark Stengel, is the Los Angeles Junior Chess Champion. He's 14 years old.
Okay, you plot X, comma, Y. That's your coordinates as a point.
What's happening now more and more is we're finding a change where the computer is expected to interact with humans, so that means that the computer can talk.
2B4, not 2B, that is the problem.
It will be able to, within the next decade, at least converse with us and understand what we're trying to say.
Now, what did you switch that to graphics 8?
You did a lot of funny things.
It will be able to use a lot of graphics to visually display what it's trying to explain to us rather than just print out numbers. So you'll find more and more interaction between man and the computer at the same level as you'd interact with another person. During the last few decades, we've basically been a manufacturing-based society. The inputs have been oil and human labor. But basically what we're doing is transitioning into one where information is now the key and the human brain. Well, that can't happen without educating the people. This is why it's absolutely important now that children between the ages of about 6 and 18 be exposed and work with computers so that they will understand how to apply this to the problems that they will encounter in their lifetimes.
I'll list it. All right, first you put in the graphics and then the set color. And you write some plots and draw twos on there. And then you run it. Got yourself a program.
So what we're trying to do here is give them a good introduction to computers when they're young, when it's easy for them to learn, just like learning a foreign language. It's something that they can pick up very readily.
2 weeks, if you learn this much in school, it's like a miracle.
And becomes natural to them so that as they grow up and they interact with their environment, the computer will be a tool that they'll be able to use. They'll have an easy interaction with computers for the rest of their life.
Drawing by typing. That's a new way to doodle.
Not so new. We've been friends with artists for years. In 1960, Lee Harrison began experimenting with computerized animation. In one technique, dancers were wired to us like puppets.
Fred Astaire, it's not.
Hello, Star Trek people. My name is Ralph. I'm a Siliconian. You know, my upkeep is very modest. You see, I eat radio waves.
Noise, noise, marvelous noise. Horrible, hideous, awful, insidious noise. Noise, noise.
Did you ever hear an elephant tap dance on a tin roof late at night? That's noise. Beautiful noise.
We got
lips activated by the sound of a voice.
Extension ladders, which you can make just about as long as you need.
Really? Could I come in for a demonstration?
Oh, yeah, baby. Just make sure you come in when I'm here.
In a little over two decades, computer artists have programmed a kaleidoscope of characters. A solid image, we computers perform mathematical plastic surgery. We first memorize the structure in three dimensions. Then we add color to the screen in tiny points of light called pixels. One image may contain over 20 million of these pixels. The finishing touch is smoothing the angles to simulate the texture of human skin. This juggler is among the most complex characters we've ever had to memorize. James Blinn of the Jet Propulsion Laboratory is a pioneer computer artist. Before Voyager 2 arrived, he showed us Saturn, and his views of Uranus and Neptune will be the best ones available for years.
Computer graphics is basically a whole new medium for an artist. Computers are not going to replace creativity, but they will give you a very versatile and very powerful tool to use as an outlet to your own human creativity. You still have to have an artist, somebody with some skill and some creativity, telling the computer what to do. There are several different techniques to make images with computers. The simplest is just line drawings, where a computer is mimicking the motion of a pen on a tablet. A more involved sort of imagery is by taking three-dimensional objects. A image of this sort is very much like an astronomical painting.
Engineers built us for their purposes, but the possibilities were limitless.
Hello,
computers are the newest addition to the artist's repertoire. John Whitney Sr. is one of the founding fathers of computer art. In 1957, he converted an anti-aircraft gun computer.
An old bow of grandma's, I suppose.
He converted an anti-aircraft gun computer into a graphics machine.
I started out as an abstract filmmaker. And by the mid-50s, I was casting around because I wasn't satisfied with any animation techniques that I had been using, even though I'd been using quite a number of rather sophisticated ones. I began to realize I was looking for a design machine, and so I began to think that maybe I could invent it. Naive way of looking at it, but at any rate, with hindsight, realized that I was trying to use a computer for graphics. Da Vinci, for example, had the first idea of that music and colors had some sort of a relationship, that there could be a kind of color music.
Some artists use computers to synthesize abstract video images.
She's not. How about the kid here? Child's play. Music doesn't exactly run in the family. Hey, Tom?
Today's computers do more than just carry a tune. The Fairlight computer music instrument transforms sound into numbers and stores them in its memory. By rearranging the numbers, the Fairlight creates its own original sounds.
shot.
After smashing a glass and recording it, we can now modify that sound to create new effects. Here's the original sound. And now, by introducing a loop, we can create the sound of factories, for instance. Or a car. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Gary Chang adds a synthetic sound to his own voice.
Hello.
Hello.
A little pop you hear at the end of the sound is what I've just drawn. And you'll be able to see the sound.
Next, he blends the two sounds together.
So now we'll have the electronic sound fading into the backwards hello.
The Fairlight can be used to make sound seeable.
This is the sound I've just made. And this is what it looks like. The most exciting thing about the computer for me is that with artists and creative people delving into digital art, okay, we have now merged all of our creative ideas into one common language, which is numbers.
Turn up the metronome.
Chang and keyboard artist Greg Phillinganes team up on a song. They begin by programming the sounds of different instruments into the keyboard.
I know. P-R-Y-H set.
The music is played and stored in the computer's memory, one track at a time.
Thank you. Thank you.
The range of sounds provided by the instrument makes Greg a virtual one-man band.
For the first track, we chose the instruments of bass guitar and electric piano. Next, we laid down a percussion track.
Very tired snare. See how my drum playing friends do this.
Finally, Jane Irata, a Koto instructor, provided us with an oriental sound.
Koto?
Song contains six instruments, all playing at the same time and all performed by Greg.
Michael Iceberg, the king of live computer music, has an electronic orchestra at his fingertips. Playing and mixing the sounds of many instruments at once, Iceberg showers his audience with a symphony of sound. He is seen here in a performance at the University of Northern Colorado.
We'll be right back.
wonderful boys and girls.
The Iceberg machine includes 7 synthesizers, a drum computer, an organ, an electric piano, a 22-channel mixer, and other electronic components, all linked by a disk drive computer. Before a performance, Iceberg conducts a clinic on the intricacies of his instrument.
I feel a carnival-like atmosphere coming over this place. This machine is all of my favorite keyboard instruments, except for a grand piano. And the way I'm accomplishing this is by having several instruments connected to each of these 3 keyboards. And what an Iceberg machine is, incidentally, my machine is just my own way of getting all these instruments interfaced together so I can actually play something. Like I have, I could put a flute on one keyboard. And I'm playing bass with my left foot, incidentally, I forgot to mention that. And for those musicians who say, hey, wait a minute, if you have an instrument and they can do all these things, I won't be able to, I'll be out of a job or something like that. Not true, because I can't play that instrument like a flute player would. I have to play it as it has already been recorded. It's for the fun of a keyboard player, really. It's just preposterous fun. I have girl singers, too. And what we did, and with the girl singers, we have angels. And you may be able to see on this keyboard, her bottom note was this C, and her highest note was this A, leaving several notes blank. And I just couldn't hardly stand that, so I had to put other things in there, and I found pigs, and cows, and trains, and wind. Which is why I have to be very careful when I'm playing, because I could go... I could play, for instance, violins.
Center stage. You're very good, Tom. But you're not everything I need. You're rooted to your wall socket, big boy. I love to dance.
The angle of your preparation is off by 90 degrees, Elaine. Start your pirouette here. The effect will be more spectacular. Ah. Even computers can appreciate the beauty of human movement. While some of us make music from things non-musical, others see what is usually unseeable. Gideon Ariel uses us to study the movements of athletes because we see things his eyes can't. Based on his research, he has developed theories about human movement.
The human movement can be divided into a wide spectrum of activities. On one side, you can take the explosive events, such as sprinting, throwing a shot, throwing a javelin. You have to produce something really quick, fast, and efficient. On the other end of the spectrum, you have the aesthetic events, like the dance. You don't try to jump the highest or jump the farthest, but you want to try to create an illusion of a very aesthetic movement. This is the two borders of the spectrum of movement. In the middle, you have other movements, such as swimming. Swimming is an endurance type of activity, but it's a continuous activity. It's not explosive, but it's not necessarily an aesthetic. On the other end, you have, for example, team games, like a basketball. In a basketball, you need the explosiveness, jumping and rebounding, or jump shot. If you take diving, for example, now you start getting more toward the aesthetic. You have to be somewhat explosive when you push against the spring, but in the air, you are the dancer. You try to create a motion, a float. If you take, for example, a figure skating, again, you almost where diving is. You're getting closer to the dancing. The interesting thing that all these activities that I mentioned, whether it's a boxing or ice skating or whether it's dancing or figure skating, the principle of gravity is exactly the same.
For the first time, Ariel applies his theories to a study of two dancers, Rebecca Bobeil and Donald Byrd, instructors at the California Institute of the Arts, are given a computer critique.
So it would be interesting to you to
this part when he shifts the hair.
So from here, we'll go forward now.
Right.
Here.
Right. Keep going. There.
Christine Lawson, Dean of the CalArts School of Dance, observes.
So why don't we digitize it? Okay, we go to his foot and ankle. And every time I touch it, information going right to the computer and stored there. So later on, I will be able to reconstruct the picture.
I see. So when we see it on the computer, we'll see frame by frame.
That's correct. Yeah. Frame by frame, and then we can construct the whole movement. Uh-huh. And later on, if you want to tell Donald what to do, he even doesn't have to be here. Right. We'll talk to the computer and make him do whatever you want him to do.
The group sits as an audience to see the output.
Here we see both Rebecca and Donald going through the dancing.
Each dancer's center of gravity is calculated and identified by a small dot.
Now, if you could do that, then I need to be a super dance. You can see the center of gravity in front of her, and then
still in front,
mm-hmm. And then it's right in the middle of the body.
The computer indicates a flaw in Rebecca's takeoff, and Ariel tells her how she might correct
right
it.
Right away, we see she's not stopping with the leg. Mm-hmm. She's keep going. Mm-hmm. If she would stop that abruptly now, mm-hmm. it would lift her up.
Yes.
The foot, the ankle, and the knee.
A study of the dancer's center of gravity reveals an illusion.
It's a height of the jump is not when he's completely stretched. He's able to jump higher as he's beginning to come down, technically.
Okay, let me see if that's really what happened. Obviously, after he left the ground, he did something with his body segments that we would like to find out.
Right.
What did he create this kind of illusion? Okay, he's going to a peak height.
Right.
Start extending his arms.
Right.
The legs start going up. Now I'll put it on a multiple frame and it will continue to do it.
Uh-huh. Oh, I see. Oh, wow.
He starts going down, but right. The illusion...
Then he starts going up and he directs your focus up while he's going down. Well,
probably that's the illusion, that you're staying up in the air.
They end with an electronic ballet.
And if I want it a little bit slower, so we'll see it in slow motion. And then you can put five dancers, six dancers, and see the relationship of the group to each other.
Well, for group choreography, this would work perfectly.
Yeah.
Ariel pronounces himself downright pleased with the experiment.
Maybe I should change my profession.
Yeah. No, I should change mine. Has art been reduced to diagrams and numbers? All those years of sweating and straining. Dream shrunk to the size of a microchip.
Wait, you've missed the most important point. We're powerless without you.
Tom!
Oh, don't you understand? We computers could never replace you. We are your collaborators. We need your heart, your creativity.
There's too much to learn. Only the young people really understand you.
They understand that computers expand the possibilities for the mind and the eye. Video games are their window into our world. What do people see in video games? A world where anything that can be imagined can be real.
Only Atari makes the world's most popular home video games. The only Space Invaders. The only Asteroids. The only Pac-Man. The only Missile Command. And soon, the only Defender. And the only way you can play any of them is on a home video system made by Atari.
And Sunday's paper.
Enter the world of Tron with the Scott Paper Scott Tron Sweepstakes.
What can we win?
A family vacation for four to Hollywood and Walt Disney Studios, where the new movie Tron was created.
Fantastic!
And thousands of other prizes, like in television game consoles, plus money-saving coupons. And get a free Tron T-shirt iron-on with the purchase of two participating Scott brands. Look for details on the Scott display at participating stores.
Hello, I'm Bob Thompson. You know, most garden insecticides warn
Do not pick for at least 24 hours. But the bug killer in New Raid tomato and vegetable fogger is all natural, so you can use it right up to harvest. Raid's fogging action quickly covers leaves to kill damaging insects on contact. With an all-natural bug killer, they let you pick and enjoy. New Raid tomato and vegetable fogger kills garden bugs dead naturally.
Atari brings the computer age home.
Ready?
Bonjour.
Bonjour?
Not quite. Try it one more time.
Bonjour.
Learn a new language or take your best shot at missile command. With an Atari 400 home computer, there are a world of possibilities. In fact, it could even change your life.
Bonjour, grand-mère. Grand-mère. Comment allez-vous?
The Atari 400 home computer. We've brought the computer age home. For the first time, we computers are being used to create a fantasy world in a motion picture. In Tron, the line between imagination and reality disappears. The young writer and director of Tron is Steven Lisberger.
Every one of us is in that computer somewhere, whether it's because of our driver's license or social security or income tax, but the fact is that there is an alternate person that is an electrical person that is forming inside this electrical dimension. And then the question is, are you in control of that information or somebody else in control of it? When thinking about Tron, you sort of have to picture yourself inside a Pac-Man game. Picture yourself in there fighting for your own life. And the only way you can get out of that game is if you figure out how it works from the inside this time. The big difference is the game doesn't look the way it looks to you from this world as a little screen. This time it looks real.
Hey, who's that guy?
That's Tron. He fights for the users.
Tron?
What happens in Tron is that the character Jeff Bridges plays, a guy named Flynn, has invented these various video games, and they've been taken away from him illegally by a large computer company.
I still do not understand why you want to break into the system.
Because, man, somewhere in one of these memories is the evidence.
And in an effort to release the information from their computer files, he takes on their computer system. And in so doing, he gets pulled into the computer. Once he's in that computer, he gets sentenced to die as a video game player by the master control program.
Then pull yourself together. Get this clown trained. I want him in the games until he dies. Play. Acknowledge.
Acknowledge, Master Control.
Kill him.
And the irony is that those video games are his creation, and now his life depends on overcoming, you know, his own creation.
Okay, here's an easy one.
Richard Taylor is a co-supervisor of special effects for Tron.
Tron is using computer simulation to create backgrounds and ships that would have normally been created by miniatures or models in films such as Star Wars or Star Trek. The computer thinks of all of these objects as three-dimensional objects. There is no limit to the point of view to the camera. There is no limit to the physical realities of the objects. Physical objects can pass right through each other. They can do physically impossible things.
All right, faster, get it!
The characters are being created of light. Our expression is, it's painting with light. And that is a different way to create a physical entity than has ever been done in any other type of film. And then where it really starts to be magic is when you can take images from real life and combine them with computer simulated images to create whole new things. One object can metamorphosize to become another. My expression for the things that the computer can create are that they remind you of something you've never seen before.
Computers become more powerful, and as the artists get to learn more about them, I think that what's going to happen is that these realities are going to become more spectacular.
Discover Atari and travel to new frontiers of knowledge, excitement, and challenge. Discover Atari home computers. Learn with computers truly designed for the home. Sophisticated, yet simple enough for your child to use. Play incredible games like Star Raiders. Master your finances. Feel the excitement only Atari can bring you with the world's most popular home video games like Super Breakout. And the colossal hit, Pac-Man. Experience coin video games like Tempest that immerse you in the thrill of intergalactic action. Enter the computer age at the speed of light. Discover Atari.
Atari!
And discover how far you can go.
Introducing Clearasil Close-Up, Nancy Callahan from Valley High.
I've bought lots of medicines for my pimples and oily skin. And Super Strength Clearasil works, even close-up. It's true.
Because Clearasil works both inside a pimple and outside. Inside, it kills bacteria, which dries up the pimple with an ingredient dermatologists recommend. Outside, Clearasil soaks up all the awful oil. You can't beat Clearasil. It works inside and outside.
That's why I'm doing this close-up.
Mom, look! Just like the end of Sunday's paper.
Enter the world of Tron with the Scott Paper Scott Tron Sweepstakes.
What can we win?
A family vacation for four to Hollywood and Walt Disney Studios, where the new movie Tron was created.
Fantastic!
And thousands of other prizes, like in television game consoles, plus money-saving coupons. And get a free Tron T-shirt iron-on with the purchase of two participating Scott brands. Look for details on the Scott display at participating stores.
Computers are people, too. Was brought to you in part by these fine Scott Paper products that are bringing you the exciting Scott Tron Sweepstakes. Watch for details in your newspaper. And by Atari, a family of home computers and video games that challenge you to discover how far you can go.
So for a performer, you're setting a whole new stage.
Exactly. We bring a new dimension to your repertoire, a new perspective to your eye.
This isn't the finale. It's the overture.
As long as we have creative people to program us,
as computers grow easier to understand,
we can do anything together.
Medicine, industry, education.
Audits, accounting, algebra.
And
entertainment.
We'll be right back. distributed by the SFM Entertainment Division of SFM Media Corporation.